This next song is a poem come monologue. It's the first probably monologue I've written. It's very long. And do you remember last year when all the crowd was spilling onto the ground in the matches? And no one could understand why this is happening. And the truth has never come out until tonight. It was my Uncle Will's fault. All those thousands of people on the field, my uncle's fault. See, what he didn't have a ticket, so what he did a shameful thing. He went dressed as an ambulance man. I mean, who's going to ask an ambulance man now? You got a ticket to us? He wouldn't, would you? Ingenious mind. But the thing was, everybody got to hear about it in the village, and they all went in the end. And there were these thousands of ambulance men. Can you imagine that? Anyway, the thing is called The Incredible Plan. Or, where there's a will, there's a way. There's a story that's told in the valleys, and I'll tell it as best as I can. The story of one Will McGonagall Morgan. And of his incredible plan. It all started off on a cold winter's night, a night that was strangely so still, when the rugby club's general committee sign-dyed their tickets, Eck, Will. Mind you, he was in the wrong. Oh, yes, we knew all along. There was no point in petitions or pickets. No, he was caught with this woman at the back of the stand with a club's allocation of tickets. Anyway, Will was sign-dyed. He broke down and cried. I've never seen a man in such sorrow, 'cause like Judas of old, he'd sold more than gold with a Scotland and Wales game tomorrow. Then he had this idea. He'd go in disguise. He had it all drawn up and planned. And he went to the game, to his family's shame, as one of the St. Albans band. Back in the village, they all got to know. Make one for me, will you? They'd say. They'd ask, any chance for one against France? And fair play, like, what could he say? So he put an ad in the Guardian to employ a few men, starting Monday. And he did. He started some men, I think, about 10 on 3 shifts and some working Sunday. They made about 300 or 400 when the night shift was sent 2 till 10. The jigs were all changed and the tools rearranged. And they started an ambulance man. Then they ran out of buttons and bandage. And policemen were next on the plans. Whilst B shift made refs with dark glasses, Alsatians, white sticks and tin cans. Then production was brought to a standstill. And the union could quite understand when management tabled the motion. Things are getting a bit out of hand. I'll never forget the day of the match. The likes of I'll ne'er see again. I can see them all still coming over the hill, hundreds and thousands of men.
Convoy ourselves a convoy trekking through the night. Yes, we got ourselves a convoy.
Ain't she a beautiful sight? Rubber duck, get a moon.
Convoy.
Rubber duck, get a moon. Rubber duck.
The refs came in four double deckers. It was going exactly to plan. And the St. Albans band came in lorries. And the police in a Griffender van. No, I'll never forget the day of the match. The likes of I'll ne'er see again. When Queen Street was full of Alsatians and the pubs full of ambulance men. It was then I saw Will for the first time. I was standing on the steps by the grand. He was in a camel hair coat, dressed up as a goat. Marching in front of the band. It was then that the accident happened. The roads were all slippy and wet. He was knocked down by a man in a greengrocer's van. And they took him to Davis the vet. Now, Davis, the vet's a bit short-sighted. He said, I'm afraid it's his heart. But he wouldn't have lived longer, even if he'd been stronger. His eyes are too far apart. The funeral was held on a Monday. The biggest I'd ever seen. The wreaths came in four double deckers. And there was one from Prince Charles and the Queen. Sorry, from the Prince of Wales and the Queens. There were sprays there from 3,000 policemen. And one from the St. Albans band. And the bearers were refs with Alsatians, dark glasses, white sticks and tin cans. We sang at the graveside. Aye, we sang at the graveside the old funeral hymns. And we all went to comfort his son. What made him sad, he said, was that dad had died not knowing we'd won. I couldn't sleep for most that night. I kept thinking of what he had said. Dad had died, not knowing we'd won. So I dressed when I got out of bed. And I walked again to that hillside, to that last resting place on a hill. It was all quiet. It was all quiet, save when I leant over the grave and I shouted, "We are mad, young Will!" And that story is told in the valleys. And I've told it as well as best as I can. The legend of one William McGonagall Morgan. And of his incredible plan.